To add text in Procreate, first choose whatever color you want your text to be. I'm going to choose purple. Go to your Actions menu, choose Add, Add Text, and a text box will appear. Type in your word or phrase. You can resize your text box by dragging these nodes out to make it either wider or taller. To adjust the font name and size, double tap on any area of your text and highlight all of it so that it all has that blue outline around it. You'll notice this little menu pops up here. To change the font, tap on the font name from that menu. You can also tap on the AA right down here. This brings up your style options. On the left-hand side here, you can scroll through and find different fonts. Some fonts have additional styles in this pane right here, like regular or italic, bold, heavy. You can increase the size of your font using this slider. You can either drag the slider or tap on that to type in a specific number. By the way, if you're trying to drag to a precise size and you're having a hard time getting it, while your pencil is on the slider, you can move your pencil further away from it, and moving left and right will allow you to get more precision. Tracking increases the amount of space in between your letters, or decreases the amount of space. Kerning is for adjusting space between individual letters. Leading increases the amount of space between each line of text in your block of text. And baseline adjusts the position of the line that your letters rest on, which is called the baseline, within the text box. You can decrease your opacity here, which makes your text more transparent or more opaque. I recommend not adjusting opacity in this setting because you can adjust your layer opacity later on. And then finally, over here, you have different alignment attributes. You can underline your text, outline your text, make it vertical. Sometimes doing that makes it fall off the screen. You can toggle on all caps by tapping that little button right there. You'll notice that made all of that go back to regular sentence case. You can highlight just certain areas of your text, like if I want Shakespeare to be capitalized, I can highlight just Shakespeare and toggle that button. I can also change the font of just that portion. You can change the color of your font by selecting all of it, tapping on your color up here, and adjusting the color. Once you've committed those changes, you'll notice that within your layers, you have a new layer. The layer preview has an A on it, and it's named whatever text you had written. To edit your text, you can tap on the layer and choose Edit Text. Now you can make changes to your text. Again, if you want to edit the settings, tap on the little A in the bottom right. But if you notice that nothing's changing, it's because you need to actually highlight your text and make those changes. You can cancel to discard any changes that you've made. So once you have your text written, you can move your text by tapping on the arrow and repositioning it on the canvas. You can also increase the size of it, like this. Text is created in a vector format so that you can change the size, like I just did, or the rotation, or the position, even the opacity by tapping on the N and decreasing your opacity without losing any quality. You can duplicate your text layer by swiping it to the left and choosing Duplicate. With your layer selected, you can change the text color. And again, you can do certain changes to it and it remains typable. So even though this is a copy of that original text layer, I can still edit the text and change it if I wanted. Now there are certain adjustments that you do that rasterize your text, meaning that it's no longer editable. This means that you can paint and add other adjustments to your text, but then you won't be able to come back and type anything else with the text. For example, I'm going to take this text layer and I'm going to go to my adjustments and apply a Gaussian blur by dragging the slider to the right. Now when I open my layers panel, you can see I have two versions of this layer. I have the purple text on top and I have that shadow on the bottom. The purple text, I can still go in and edit the text. But because the text below it has been rasterized with that Gaussian blur. I can no longer edit it. So tapping on that layer, I can no longer choose edit text. You'll notice there's a difference in how these layers appear as well. So this one on top, the purple one, has an A right here. That's the one where we can continue to edit the text, and this one does not. Okay, so that rasterize option, if you tap on your layer and choose rasterize, that's going to rasterize the text layer, and now you can no longer edit it. So like I showed you with the Gaussian blur layer, I just added that adjustment and it automatically rasterized my text layer. Sometimes if you try to do something to a text layer, it will ask you if you want to rasterize the layer or edit the text. So I just tried to paint on this layer. If I choose rasterize, now it will allow me to paint on the same layer of the text, and you saw that error at the top. It said it was going to rasterize. You have to undo twice if you want to get back to your editable text. I recommend just if you're going to paint to just do that on a separate layer so that you can keep your text editable. Hey, if you liked this video, subscribe to our channel for more and check out our other tutorials on Procreate. You also might like our free iPad calligraphy practice brush. It's a color changing brush that helps you learn how to control your pressure as you're writing calligraphy. You can get the free brush plus a bunch of practice worksheets available on our website at lovelyloops.com/freebrush. Check the description to download yours. Thanks again for watching and happy digital lettering.